All right. Our house is just about done. We're going to be. Are we allowed to read the Talmud involving the seven laws? If it involves the seven laws. But for right now, Snow, the Kitzer Shulchan Aruch is the. What is that? The Kitzer Shulchan Aruch is what you should be studying, the Divine Code. Going to the Talmud now, unless you understand how to study the Talmud, and the Talmud is a bit on the difficult side, unless you understand Talmudic methodology, I'd stay away from it. If I were you, I really would. Because if you're going to go into the Talmud, you got to go into the Talmud with a study buddy. And if you got a study buddy, that is a way to get involved in it. But if you don't have a study buddy and you don't understand how to study the Gemara, you're in trouble. The Talmud is a fascinating work. I'm about 30 pages into Sanhedrin. It's just fascinating. How do you explain to people when they ask, what is your religion? It's hard to explain, even as I learn what Noahide beliefs are. My daughter just says she's Jewish, and it's not a religion. It's a way of life. So how can you explain these types of questions? Good question. Heather, what you would do is you would say, you're a Bas Noach. That means you're a person who follows the seven laws after the flood. And just delineate what those laws are. That's very simple. You are a righteous Gentile. You are a Bas Noach. Being a Jew is a way of life. It is a way of life. I mean, everything that you do from the time you get up to the time you go to bed is delineated. It was a good question. Good. Last night we had some phenomenal questions. We're going to have some wonderful questions tonight, I can see. Yes, but you can't just say you're Jewish. Why not? That's the easiest way. I'm a Yid. And that's what people, and that seems to be what people understand. I'm a Yid. Yeah, they don't understand. Right. And you need a Hebraic understanding to go with the Talmud. English and other language do not fully translate well. Exactly. A Yid. A Yid's a good thing. Judaism for Gentiles. I don't understand what that means, Marvin. Okay, explain that you have a biblical lifestyle like, there you go, that's good. Yiddish. Can I trouble you for something, my sweet? Thank you. Anybody want to know why I have just water in here and not my normal Arnold Palmer? Anybody want to take a wild guess on that? Thank you. Exactly. There is kidneys in the. There's kidneys in the lemonade. All right. Thank you. You put that over here? Well, it's very kind. Thank you. Okay. Any other questions? If not, let's go to the Torah portion. That was a PM I just got. What? Hang on a second. I read somewhere that Noahides are part of the Masons. No. No, there is no Masonic affiliation within the B'nai Noach movement. Are there B'nai Noach who are Masons? No doubt. I would guess yes. But the only thing out there in a religion that's tied with Masonry at all would be Mormonism. Was Noah an albino? No. Not even close, although there are some people who are Masons that might be considered. Yeah, no problem with that. Freemasonry. Kiba, Google Freemasonry. I'll tell you what they are. No, Masons are not just Christians. There are Muslims, there are Jews, there are Christians, there are Baptists, you name it, they're out there. You don't find too many Catholics that are Masons, though. Yeah, there's nothing to do with... Masonry is a fraternal organization. If you don't know what Masonry is, I'm sure you've heard all sorts of horrible things about Masonry. Here's what Masonry is in short. Let me tell you what Masonry is. Masonry is a fraternal organization that helps to make a good man better, period. That's what Masonry is. That's it. If you're a bad person, you can't be a Mason. If you're a felon, you can't be a Mason. If you're not a nice, upstanding person, you can't be a Mason. You have to have character. You have to be honest, forthright, upstanding within your community in order to become a Mason. And you have to ask. You can't be invited in, at least not in the state of California. Okay, that answer your question? Yes, they can. Nice. Yeah, but they don't do all those rituals. Yeah. Nice. Masons are good people. 33rd degree? 33rd degree is an honorary title. 32nd degree Mason is a Scottish Rite Mason. 33rd degree is an honorary title. Yeah, good. There are two forms of Masonry out there. There's ancient free and accepted and free and accepted. Free and accepted started, was first. Free and accepted started in 1735. And ancient free and accepted started after that. How we got off of Masonry, I don't have any idea. But that's your answer. Okay, anything else? Hey, where's Francis? Jews were Masons, yes. Here's an interesting little tidbit about Masonry. Heather, this is true. No, Heather, this is true. There were Jews in Europe during the Shoah who were being marched off to camp. They put a little blue flower on their lapel called a forget-me-not. The German soldiers that were also secret Masons, very quiet Masons, helped them and turned their back as they took off out of the lines, heading off to the camps. So yes, Masons help Masons. That's a very true story. That's a true story. That's been documented. Yeah. So people who say that Masons are this, Masons are that, have no idea what Masons are. Masons are a cornerstone of our of this country. 33 signers of the Constitution of the United States of America were Masons. Our first president was a Mason. Jack the Ripper wasn't a Mason. Yeah, murderers can't be Masons. Okay?